Hi guys, it's Zoe from Stick It To Them Nails again, and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how I do this hammered copper design. This nail actually feels quite textured, but it's not sharp or rough at all. Textured nails can be really good for people that tend to pick at their cuticles or want to pick at their nails. If the nails are actually designed with that texture in mind, you'll find that it gives them something to actually pick at without damaging the nails or damaging their cuticles. So this set was actually inspired by a set of nails that I came across on Etsy. I believe they're actually real copper and they're made by a process called electroforming, which I know nothing about, but I did really love the look and wanted to do something similar. So the chrome that we're going to be using to make these nails is the most beautiful rose gold chrome. I find a lot of rose gold chromes that are out there for nails are actually really like a pink gold. So this one is what I would call like a true rose gold. However, I wanted to go for a copper look for these ones, so I decided to put black underneath to give it a little bit more of a coppery look as opposed to rose gold. So as you can see, I've just done two coats of black gel polish and cured. The next step you want to do is grab your favorite no wipe top coat that you use for creaming nails and do a thin coat of that. If you have a thicker one and a thinner one by any chance, I would suggest using the thinner one because we are going to put a few layers on these nails that will make them a little bit thicker. Then you'll do a partial cure of that like you would normally for any chrome. So go ahead and grab your chrome and we're going to use some silicone tools. As you can see, I've got one with two ends here, a pointed end and the normal flat end. Of course, you don't have to use a silicone tool to apply your chrome. That's just my preference, although the pointed end of the tool will come in handy a little bit later on. I am obsessed with this chrome. It is the truest rose gold colored chrome that I've seen for nails. A lot of them are very pinky, and if you are like me and have loved rose gold since before it became famous, then you will love this chrome color. So now I'm going to use Sticky Bond from Planet Nails just to run around the very edges of the chrome. This will really help your next coat, whether it be a top coat or a builder gel or whatever you would normally apply over chromes. This will really help it to adhere and to stop it from chipping. That will just take a few seconds to air dry. And then I'm going to come in with my beloved Lastic and add one coat to seal the chrome in. You can skip this step if you want to. I like to do it so that if I make a mistake with my next layer, then if I need to remove it, I'm not going to disturb the chrome. If you don't have Lastic, you can use a builder gel or a builder in a bottle. Pop that in the lamp to cure, and then we are on to the fun part. I'm going to be using Iconic from Planet Nails, which is their hybrid acrylic gel product. So squeeze some out of the tube. It's always better to start with less because you can add more later, but given that it's a tube, it's very hard to put any extra product back in. Now we don't want an incredibly thick layer, but we do want a little bit of this product to be on there because this is what we're going to use to make our texture. Now the brush that I'm using here was supplied with the Iconic that I bought from Planet Nails. I think when I bought it, it came in a kit. So I think it's an acrylic brush. I don't use acrylic, but it does have number 4 on it. So I'm sure that will mean something to those of you that do use acrylic. I really like the way that it works with this product. Iconic is really nice. It's got a firmness to it, but not really, really firm. So it's actually probably the easiest of the acrylic hybrids that I've tried to mold into place. You want to make sure you get this product right down to the edges, but not obviously as much on the edges as you would put in the center of the nail. So once I've applied the bulk of the product, I will go through and make sure that the Iconic is going all the way to the edges of the nail, as I said before. It certainly doesn't need to be a perfect application. You basically want the bulk of the product down the center of the nail, and you want some product to reach all the way down the sides, but not be too thick at the edges. I do tend to get a bit caught up in what I'm doing and play with it for far too long, but just make sure once you are happy with where the product is that you don't cure it, because we're going to do something else first. So to make the texture on the nail, we're going to use a medium-sized dotting tool and just start dotting into the nail. It's a pretty simple technique really, but it has a really good result. When I did this, I was just thinking basically, okay, hammered copper, they're literally just getting a hammer and hammering a certain tool into the copper over and over again. So I sort of imagined doing that with my dotting tool in the place of a hammer. You will need to have some alcohol nearby so that you can dip the dotting tool into it occasionally. You might find that it just gets a little bit sticky after a while and wants to sort of pull on the Iconic. So that's when you need to go and dip into the alcohol again, and it will be nice and smooth and easy to use. Now I know it's quite hard to see what I'm doing, like you can see that there's indentations, but it's really hard to see what's what. That's what it looks like in person. That's not just the camera and, you know, what it looks like on film. It's really hard to see what you're actually doing with this technique. You've got a metallic surface underneath and then you've got a clear surface on top, and it is really difficult. So just do your best. The main thing you need to pay attention to is that as you go down the nail, you might find you're sort of bunching up your product a little bit further towards the tip. So you might want to stop and start sort of pushing back the opposite direction, if that makes sense, just to be aware of where the bulk of the product is. And the other thing you might like to do is go down the edges of the nail, as you just saw me doing. I just like to go down the edges all the way around the sides and just push those parts back a little away from the edge towards the center of the nail. So you don't want to push the product down so that it pushes off the edge of the nail down the sides. So that's where I come in and I push it back up, if that sort of makes sense, from the side upwards, so that you don't end up with a bulk down the edges. And also, because it is so difficult to see what's actually going on, I think that depending on your product, I found the Iconic did settle a little bit, so the indentations that I made at the start, by the time I got to the bottom of the nail, I don't think they were quite as deep as they were at the start. So as you can see, I've decided to go back up the top and redo a lot of those indentations, which really just sort of, you know, it may or may not be needed. If you don't do it, you might get a slightly softer effect, which I have played with as well and also does look very cool. So, you know, play around with it as much as you feel is necessary. Once you've done all of that and you've decided you're happy with it, you can pop it in the lamp and give it a full cure. So here it is cured. We're not finished yet. We've got some other things to do first before the nail is completely finished. But you can just see that it is textured, but it's not sharp. So we're pushing into it with a round tool, so you're not ending up with any sharp edges. Now the next step is to grab out that thin no wipe top coat that we used earlier, and we want a tiny amount on the brush, and we're going to just gently go over that nail. You don't want to fill in any of the ridges. So this is the most important part here. If you fill those indents with your top coat, When you go to put chrome on again, which is the next step, you'll have a smoother effect than really getting the effect of you know, all those indentations that we've just spent all that time making. So I do spend a little time, a very small amount, as I said, on my brush, trying to sort of jabbing it all over the place, really. It's not very delicate, but just sort of trying to get top coat a tiny amount in as many of those indents as we can. And if you do get a little bit too much and you see some areas where it looks like it's filled in some holes, I'll actually go through and try to remove that the extra top coat from those dents. So I'm sort of doing that now, trying to remove some of that. And when you're ready, you will do a partial cure the same as you will for your chrome. Now you can grab out your chrome again and go over the nail again. I like to be fairly liberal here. We really do want to get chrome over as much of this nail and into as many of those dents that we can. So I am quite liberal with it, as you can see. I don't try to use a tiny amount. I will just pretty much go at it. Now, the reason that we did the original chrome layer over the black gel polish is so that if you end up missing any spots, or if anything gets wiped off when you put your top coat or your builder gel over this chrome layer because it is so uneven, you won't see the black through it, you'll just see the other chrome layer, which actually creates a bit of depth to it as well. And now you can see where the pointed end of this silicone tool comes into its own. So I know it looks quite fiddly, it really is worth it though, and it really doesn't take that long. I'm not being super perfect about it, I'm just kind of trying to poke it in all of those indents that we made earlier. You could use the side of the flat silicone tool that we used before. You could just use one of the edges of that, one of the pointed corners. But I did buy a 5-pack of these silicone tools when I first bought them years ago, and this pointed one was in there and it seemed pretty perfect for this job. So take your time, try and get in as many of those indents as you can, give it a once over and check if you've covered everything. And then when I'm done, I grab my little dusting brush that I have for my chromes and give it a little dust to remove all the extra powder. You do want to be quite gentle though. You don't want to use a brush that's too harsh and actually scratch off any of the chrome that we've just put on. So this is what we're left with at the moment after we have applied that chrome and dusted off any extra. It would be awesome if we could leave it like this, but of course we need to seal in that chrome, otherwise it would just all wash off. Okay, so next we need to seal this in, and we need to be really careful here. I've gone in with my Lastic again to really seal it in and keep it nice and safe in there. And Lastic is great for stopping chromes from chipping as well. But you have to be really careful that you are very gentle with this. So I found with one or two of the nails when I first started trying this technique, was that if I was too rough with my Lastic, then I was actually taking off some of the chrome that I had just put on. We definitely don't want that, because the chrome on top of the texture is what really makes this design come to life. So you do want to run down the edges with a decent amount to make sure that the edges, of course, always with chrome, we need to make sure those edges are really well sealed. But then again, very small amount of product on your brush, very gently going over the nail, and if you find that you have filled in any of those holes with too much product, then you can wipe over them again and try and remove any excess. I always keep a separate bottle of my Lastic and my top coats to use with glitters and chromes. As you can see, you always end up with a bit of chrome on your brushes. You do want to make sure you don't have too much chrome on it after you have done this, otherwise it might indicate that you have been a little rough and taken a little bit too much product off. Once you're happy with that, pop it in the lamp and cure it. So for this particular nail, I decided to come in again and do another coat of the Lastic. Because it is so textured, there might be some areas that you miss, and if you or your client goes and washes your hands, you'll end up taking off any chrome that is not sealed in, of course. So because there is a lot of texture, I just thought I would go over it a second time and see if I could fill in any little bits that may not have got any Lastic on them in the first place. And the good thing about a second coat is that you can be a little bit rougher because you've got that first coat sealing it in already. Then of course we pop that in the lamp to cure it, and then you can come in with your final top coat. Again, I like to use the thinner top coat. This nail does end up quite thick just because of the nature of what it is. So the fact that it's already quite thick, combined with the fact that I really want to keep that texture in there, means that I want to keep using the thinnest products available. So I definitely don't want to use a thick builder gel in place of the Lastic or a thick top coat. Again, I like to use a relatively small amount, and it looks a little bit crazy, I think, because I'm sort of going all over the place in, you know, different directions, and certainly treating the nail very differently to how I would normally. But again, the idea is just to get in as many of those nooks and crannies as you can without filling them with product. So keep going with that, getting everything as well as you can, and when you are happy with it, you can pop it in the lamp and cure it for the last time. I like to give these a really good clean after they're done, purely to remove any extra chrome that might not have been encased in your top coat or your Lastic. Because of the texture, it is possible you may miss something even with both coats, but that is of course why we put in that first chrome layer, so you won't see any of the black underneath. You could even give them, if they're press-ons, give them a wash under the tap, or get your client to wash their hands if you want to. It's not really necessary, but it will help to clean them up and get rid of any extra bits of chrome powder that may not have been encased. So that is it for this tutorial, guys. I hope that it was helpful and everything made sense. I really love this design. I had the idea to do it, as I said earlier, and I was so excited that it actually worked out, because it doesn't always do. If you did enjoy it and it was helpful, I would love if you would like the video and subscribe to my channel. And don't forget to check the description box below for links to where to get all the products. I hope you're all staying safe, and I'll see you in the next one.